Hey YouTube, it's Adam from I'm a Music Mogul and welcome to another video. Today is going to be a quick one, and today we're going to explain the importance of your I/O buffer settings, your input and output, and why it causes your Logic session to constantly get that overload notice non-stop. If you're not running sort of a really fast computer with a lot of RAM, you're probably experiencing that message quite frequently, and here's how to fix just that. In the top left-hand corner, we're going to go Logic Pro X. We're going to go to Preferences, Audio. And what we're going to be focusing on right here is the I/O buffer size, or your input-output buffer size. Now, I'm going to keep things really, really simple here. If you are mixing, so that means you're not doing any recording, you're just simply mixing and maybe adding in some softer instruments, what you want to do here is increase the buffer size. So you can put it all the way up to 1024, and it will stop you from getting that overload message. So if you change that to 1024 samples, when you are mixing or recording softer instrument tracks, not live audio, then this should help you out with that. It does sort of increase the latency that's happening on your machine, but you won't notice it because everything is being delayed by the same amount. Now, with that said, if you are recording live audio, recording vocalists, recording guitars, drums, whatever it may be, you're going to want to set this I/O buffer size to 128 or below. So the lower it is, you're going to get less and less latency. And this is what I recommend for recording live audio, vocalists, drums, guitars, whatever it may be. Now, with that said, hopefully that cleared up that mess over there. So you're going to stop getting that annoying overload protection delay that Logic always pops up with. And really the other thing that you could look at and maybe adjust further is the process buffer range. Now, just like the I/O buffer size, the higher you set the buffer range, it's going to take less stress off the CPU, but it's going to increase latency. The smaller it is, it's going to decrease the latency but have more stress on the CPU. So I recommend just leaving that at medium. Now finally, if you are recording tracks, you got your I/O buffer size set to low to further decrease the latency and get pretty much near zero latency, go over to General and make sure you deselect softer monitoring. So that means when the audio is coming into Logic Pro 10, it's not processing it and then sort of monitoring it back to your headphones through software. You're pretty much hearing it directly off of the preamp. So hopefully that clears up that whole debate on how to fix the overload protection. It's really mainly focuses on the I/O buffer size. And just remember, lower the number, less latency, more stress on the CPU. Do that for recording. Higher the I/O buffer size, it is for mixing and maybe recording some MIDI information, higher latency. And hopefully you guys can fix your overload protection alerts and not get them anymore. If you do have any other tips, you can let me know in the comment section below, or just want to chat, let's talk there. And if you did like this video, remember thumbs up and share it. If you are new to I'm a Music Mogul, remember to hit that subscribe button for more great videos like this one. I'll talk to y'all soon. Later. Peace.